Hey guys, Moose78 here. Be sure to never miss another upload and click on the notifications icon to be alerted whenever a new video goes live. Hey, what's going on guys? Welcome back to American Truck Simulator. I am Moose78 and this is my ATS Let's Play series, Stories from the Road. Upload this twice a week, typically on a Tuesday and Thursday. Hope you guys are doing well today, by the way. We are back in the Kenworth W900. Finally got it updated for 1.4. Really like this truck. Changed the paint scheme up, went to a black and gray with little white accents around the logo there. Just really glad to be back in this truck. Got the new SEI wheel in it. Really enjoying that wheel pack. But we are down here in Tucson, Arizona. And we're going to hop out here and see what kind of freight we got available with the place we're at. Spreadsheet is updated. Got a couple new things in, nothing really major. Just installed a Smarties Fontaine Phantom from the Steam Workshop, so hopefully we can get a load with that today. And there we go. That's gonna give me, options. Okay. So I can either go with the default trailer, or we can go with that. Now we'll just go ahead and go with that, I guess. And that is going to Los Angeles. So that'd be a nice little run for us. Actually, I think it's the one just right back there. Looks like I'm gonna have to go in and adjust track IR because my head's just whipping around about 1,000 miles an hour right now. So I'll try to be aware of that as we play through today. Using the N14-600 chipped engine sound, probably my favorite engine sound. Of course, by Creech Bomb. Get all hooked up here. Should be able to get this on the first go. There we go. Get it all coupled up. And I'll probably go and change the wheels on it. That way we can have some aluminum wheels. But great looking trailer nonetheless. We're all hooked up good. Trailer brakes are working good. Pull up here and do a quick pre-trip inspection. It's kind of something I want to try to incorporate each episode. Four ways look to all be working good. I The lights are lighting up on the tractor. We're good there. Trailer lights are all looking good. I think we are ready to head to Los Angeles. It's good to start to get back into the swing of things. For right now, my schedule is back to normal, so I'm really happy about that. Hopefully it kind of stays like that. So things kind of got hectic there, but kind of back on track. Let's see, how heavy are we here? Not bad at all. It's 12,000 pounds. Off we go. I'm just really excited to have the Kenworth back in game, back updated. Of course, updated from 1.4. And again, I just really love these Steering Creations wheels. This kind of adds a little something extra to the game. You know, I know mileage varies on stuff like that, but this is one that I actually really have enjoyed. And just a quick update on the graphics overview video that I've been talking about for the last couple weeks. That should be live tomorrow. I think I went back and I've shot that thing probably 4 different times now. But finally got it done, and I think you guys will hopefully find that useful. I think I can beat that car. I think I can. There we go. But the first few times that I did it, I felt like I kind of missed out on a couple key points. So I just wanted to go back and make sure that was complete as possible. Like I said, that should be live tomorrow. So be on the lookout for that. But it's just good to be back in ATS. Got everything pretty much updated. There's a couple other things I needed to do. Still need to get the utility ironed out. Hopefully get that done by the end of this week. Like I said, with my schedule kind of being back to normal now, I should have a little bit of time to get that done. Get that updated and out to everyone. That's probably the favorite part of the sound mod right there for me, is that Jake brake. Turn my four ways on, see if that helps me get over a little bit better. There you go, right. Huge shout out right there to RKE Ghost for, sorry if I got your name wrong, by the way. But he had hit me up on a couple different videos and said, hey, when you're getting on the ramps, just click on your four ways and traffic will either get over or will stop for you, and there we go. I forgot to do it the last video, but it's just slicker than deer gut on a doorknob right there, as Uncle Jesse would say. So hopefully I can remember to do that in the future, because that makes getting on the ramps a whole lot easier. Latest image. MHA map back in here, so that's good. Got the W900 updated, like I said. Crew set there and good to go. Almost missed the exit there. Almost though, almost. Over the weekend, I actually hopped on and played some multiplayer with some of the KTI guys. That was a lot of fun. There were some other guys that, kind of hang out with when we do the multiplayer thing. I think at one point in time we had probably get on the road, Moose, get on the road. There we go. We had probably close to 7-8 guys in our convoy, which I thought was pretty cool. And then the last run, there was just 5 of us, but we ran from all the way to Holbrook, all the way up to Redding, California, and we all took contracted runs. So that way we were governed to 65, and that was a really good run. Didn't come across a whole lot of traffic. Everything went pretty smooth. There were a couple goofballs running around in the pilot cars, kind of trolling people a little bit, but nothing too bad. And I think there was one truck that was kind of stopped in the middle of the interstate. But other than that, everything went pretty smooth. So hopefully I can get back into some more multiplayer here soon. I don't really do it a whole lot. I mean, probably less than 5 times that I've got on there and played, but it was definitely a fun experience, and I definitely want to do it again in the future. You can see one of Jazzy Cat's trailer mods. Definitely want to start using some of that stuff. Really a couple cool loads that I want to use there. And just kind of mix it up on the channel a little bit, but I spent some time last night getting the W900 updated, so that's why I wanted to use it today. Just get it out and knock the dust off of it a little bit. Stay over here in the left-hand lane because I'm seeing some brake checking going over there on the right. Got this car trying to pass me over here. Ready for the rescale. Definitely ready for that. What I'm hoping for is when that does go live, that they just drop a bombshell on us and we get like 3 new trucks with the expansion. Okay, what is going on up here? Seeing a lot of brake lights. Jazzy Cat's mods there. I think that's just really cool how now there are actual, company trucks in the AI. Really cool. I tried doing something like that back in the day for hauling and just got nowhere. So big kudos and big thanks to Jazzy Cat for sharing that with the community. But one thing we were talking about during our little multiplayer session there over the weekend was, you know, what truck we thought would be in the game next, and everyone pretty much seems to think that the 389 is a lock. That's probably the safe bet since all the trucks in game already are all Packer trucks, Kenworth and the Peterbilts. So that's probably the safe bet. Like I said, I'd love to see him just drop a bombshell on us and go, boom, here are 3 new trucks. of the Volvo, the Cascadia, and the 389, which we've all seen kind of teaser screenshots of kind of here and there with different DLC packs and stuff like that. Reset the cruise here. I think it was Dogebuilt that pointed out during the Wheel Pack DLC, when that was first announced, there's a couple screenshots of the 389 in there. I think they also had a Volvo in there and maybe the Cascadia. I'm not too sure on that one, but I know for sure the Volvo, that was featured in there a couple times. So I think it'd just be awesome if that's, that does come to fruition. Really haven't seen a whole lot on the blog about the rescale here lately, so, you know, of course, as soon as they do, I'll get a news video out on that. This looks good. What I might do here for the next few episodes is, like, one episode will be the, you know, this truck, and I'll just kind of use this as my kind of daily driver, and then the second video of the week, I'll just kind of do a random truck with some different loads and stuff like that. Kind of want to get some heavy haul stuff going, or at least some, you know, heavy equipment. Now that I have this updated, I really want to start using it quite a bit again, because this is probably one of my favorite trucks. So far, so good. Pretty clean run. I've actually been playing this a little bit more here lately just to kind of get reacclimated to the game. Touch up my driving skills a little bit. Still need to work on my backing up quite a bit. There were a couple funny moments during the multiplayer session where I was trying to back up, and it was getting to be a little bit brutal, but it was good times, though. Servers seem a lot more stable than what they were, you know, back when I played it a few months ago. No one was really desyncing too much. One thing I really like about the MHA map is they put the trucks and stuff at the back of the scale house to kind of, you know, kind of mix it up a little bit. Just kind of adds that immersion factor. Of course, with this thing being as light as it is, there should be no issues. Yeah, it is 41,000 pounds. So we are good to go. Would be kind of cool, though, if it somehow, you know, kind of flagged you. Just pull around the, behind the scale house and go through, like, a cutscene of, you know, getting your truck inspected or logbook inspected, something like that. Didn't use the four ways there because there wasn't anything coming, and that car was over in the right-hand lane, so... And I kind of forgot again, but... Yeah. truck do you guys want in the game next? Do you want the 389? Do you want something different? Let me know down in the comment section below. I always love hearing from you guys. I think it was the last episode I said I would love to see the Cascadia in-game. I think it's a really good-looking truck. I'm actually going to be turning here, so... Look at that, 7 miles to the gallon. Love it. So we shouldn't be too far out. Yeah, we're not too far out. Looks like we're delivering just south of LA, so... Oh, now it'll drop into 5 low. Usually takes me just a couple minutes to get the timing back down on that. But hopefully here in the next few days, I can also get my review done on the SKRS. Just kind of want to get that out there to you guys to kind of let you know my thoughts on it. If you still haven't bought one and you're kind of on the fence, maybe that'll kind of help you out a little bit. Instead of turning there, I'm just gonna go all the way down here to the end of the block and turn left there and catch it that way. Seeing everyone the song of my people. Even though I'm not supposed to do that in the city. Hey, let's just stop about a mile short. Western T680 coming at us there, pretty cool. So yeah, it's just a nice, real nice change of pace in my opinion. You get some, you know, actual company trucks mixed in with just the plain default SES trucks, various different loads on them. Really, really liking that mod. is going to turn green before we get up there. Nope. Just love the way this engine mod sounds, though. Horn sounds pretty good, too. There. Because that's why. So I think I actually have the citations and everything turned off. I keep forgetting to turn it back on, but you know, even with it off, I still, you know, stick to the speed limit and all that stuff, so it's not a huge deal. Close we are now. We are just about there. Should make a whole lot better time now that we're back out here on the highway, out of town and all that. See, it's just cool looking over there and seeing all the trucks parked and everything over there. It kind of really helps the immersion factor out a whole lot. Discovered. I don't know, I have like about umpteen different profiles, so that's probably why Carlsbad's not been discovered yet. It's probably an older profile. Just be up here on the road. right. At least I thought it was going to Bitumen. Could be wrong. That must not be. That's cool, you even got a truck parked over there at the construction thing. Right on. Inside the city, I can use the Jake brake. Try to do a little bit better job of that. Mine's a little bit more realistic. Looks like we got one more little jaunt out of the interstate, and we should be to our destination here pretty soon, I would think. This looks kind of different. I don't know if this is part of the MHA map or... This is part of the game I don't get to a whole lot. When you don't pay attention, kids. All right, so where are we delivering this thing to? Is it to Gallup? That, yep, okay. Icon is down there on the ground. There we go. Guess we'll give it a shot. Actually, just kind of glance at the clock, should probably go ahead and do that. All right, guys, that is going to wrap it up for today. Next one, we'll go ahead and back it up and all that good stuff, but just kind of glanced over the clock. Noticed that I'm running a little bit short on time, and this is starting to run a little bit long, so guess that wouldn't have been too bad to back up to. But nonetheless, we'll get it next time. If you liked today's video, just give it a like and a share. It just helps me out a bunch, helps the channel grow. And if you're new to the channel and are not already subscribed, take a look around and consider subscribing now. But guys, I'm going to cut on out of here for now. Until the next video, stay safe out there, take care, and we'll be seeing you. Hey guys, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing. Also, if you want to follow me over on the Twitters, follow the link down in the video description. And if you're looking for great gaming gear at an affordable price, then be sure to check out my No Scope Gaming Glasses affiliate link, also down in the video description. And lastly, I upload 3 days a week, so be sure to check down below for my various content playlists for any videos you may have missed. Until the next video, stay safe out there, take care, and we'll be seeing you.